guys, right now I'm actually in my new place. We've actually just moved in today. And yeah, there's still a lot of stuff that we're still gonna take care of and whatever. And anyway, I've temporarily installed my Zhongliang Skystar series ceiling fan in my room. I'm actually gonna put a regular proper ceiling fan here, either an SMC, either a really small SMC, which is what I want, or a vintage industrial ceiling fan, which is something else I've been really wanting. But I'd probably go with the SMC, to be honest, because I do need that central light. I don't really need it, but I'd rather have a central light there, because anyway, as you can see, I just hooked it up to the light fixture, and I actually haven't screwed the bulb because it is getting in the way, and I didn't want it to break. And now I'm just using my little IKEA lamp as a substitute. But when I've installed the SMC, that probably won't be a problem anymore, since the fan I want has got a light on it. Anyways, now turn it on. By the way, don't mind this. This is for my old helper, because there's one time in my old place where I had to run my fan 24/7 to deal with mold issues. But anyways, here we go. Let's see what's up. This is by the way one of the better startups. Like normally, like sometimes it would fly all over the place and it would hit the wire and stuff like that. I'll try to catch that. That's what I mean. And that's probably gonna be why I'm not really gonna start and stop this fan very often. As you can see, it was lucky enough for the air conditioner It's not enough to be able to just hook the car behind the air conditioner. If not, I would have probably just had to stick with that Midea fan for the meantime. Because I didn't want to have to drill anything, because it's a temporary install. And also we've had problems drilling here because the handyman actually drilled into a pipe at one point, so we're gonna have to get like a map of all the plumbing and whatnot in the house, so we're gonna have to do that before we drill anymore. And that is that quite a decent amount of air in this room, I gotta say. I'm gonna turn the second one off to give you guys a better gauge. Nice shot from below. Even from the high up, I'm actually feeling quite a bit of air. It's actually a pretty powerful little fan. It's very thin as well. So it uses up only like 15 watts, and that's quite a bit of air it's moving. Top view. Anyways, I'm gonna turn it off. Yeah, there's that. Now I'm gonna try to run it in reverse by spinning it the opposite direction, because that's how you reverse fans like these. Thank you. not a good sign. The card is all tangled up. I actually installed them in such a way that the card would not get tangled up when it's throwing it forward. But anyway, probably will never use get to use it in reverse because by that time I would have had my newest MC or whatever fan I choose to install. Yeah, I can use a decent amount of fan in reverse. But no, actually, it's actually pretty weak in reverse with the way the blades are designed. Anyways, yeah. Now I'm gonna put it back. And anyways, that's it. Thank you guys for watching. Hope you enjoyed this video. If you like this video, please feel free to click the like button.